Good to be back again. I'm Sulaiman. Welcome to another edition of our program, DPR, the Petroleum Industry Regulator. Today, I bring you another innovation by the Department of Petroleum Resources to monitor and enhance the downstream sector of the industry. Now, it is an inventory and regulatory tool that tracks petroleum products across retail outlets and depots in the country. It is known as Downstream Remote Monitoring System, DRMS. I got it off record that it can check hoarding. I know you love that. I do too. As well as smuggling of petroleum products. Now, this is getting interesting. Now, the secret, I repeat, the secret of this innovation is in your hand, your smartphone. But don't say I told you. But before we get to that, you know, let's see what exactly is happening in the industry. That's the DPR tidbits. Director and Chief Executive Officer of the Department of Petroleum Resources, Engineer Sereke Awalu, has described the department as a business enabler and opportunity provider in the Nigerian oil and gas industry. Engineer Awalu made this statement at the Niger Delta Modular Refinery in Ogbele, in Rivers State, when he paid a surprise visit to the facility. The director called on private investors to seize the opportunities provided by the department to create individuals, businesses, and employ more Nigerians.
This is a model that needs to be catalyzed and replicated elsewhere. And I think this is a school that other refiners, especially in the private sector, they can come to really learn how it has been done.
Engineer Awalu praised the management of Niger Delta Refinery on the progress made so far, describing what he saw as a model for other investors to learn from.
This refinery is a masterpiece, and you can see a gradual increment of capacity and product, starting from 1,000 as a topping plant, to hydroskimming plant, to fully refining plant that can produce PMS and other essential products.
The outgoing managing director of the Niger Delta Refinery, Dr. Lai Fatono, while introducing his successor, who is on a business trip in Canada, through the internet device, said the company had a humble beginning from exploration on a marginal field to refining crude from the field to produce diesel and liquefied petroleum gas, the LPG, to the refining of crude oil to produce premium motor spirit PMS.
I think the model that we have pursued is one that allows this country to pursue a journey towards energy independence and energy security.
The director and his entourage were taken round the facility that produces and refines almost 11,000 barrels of crude oil per stream day. Managing Director, Nigerian Liquefied Natural Gas Limited, Mr. Tony Atta, has stressed the need for Nigeria to maximize the use of her abundant gas resources for national transformation. Mr. Atta was of the opinion that Nigeria's richness in gas, coupled with her large population, which presents a huge market for gas, there was need for the country to be more deliberate and focused in diversifying into the use of natural gas resource. The NLNG managing director shared his thoughts recently at the second virtual Nigeria Gas Association NGA industry multi-long with the theme Powering Forward, Enabling Nigeria's Industrialization via Gas. He regretted that Nigeria and indeed Africa still suffer from lack of access to energy despite the vast gas resources available to them. He stated that Nigeria should take a cue from countries like Qatar that has utilized her gas resource to transform the country. OPEC Plus maintained its crude oil output policy at a meeting as the price of crude oil hits its highest in almost a year, a sign that deep supply cuts are draining inventories despite an uncertain outlook for demand recovery. A joint ministerial committee of OPEC Plus met virtually, pronouncing itself optimistic for a year of recovery in 2021, a draft statement reported by Reuters. Crude oil rallied from historic lows hit last year as pandemic affected demand, thanks to record output cuts by the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, and its allies known as OPEC Plus. The benchmark for Brent hit $67.52 a barrel. That's the highest since February of 2020.
Over the years, the Department of Petroleum Resources, DPR, has been carrying out its mandate of supervision and regulation of the Nigerian oil and gas industry, the cornerstone of our country's economy. It has built an enviable platform with highly trained manpower to carry out these responsibilities that cut across the value chain of the upstream, midstream, and downstream of the industry. Today, DPR and its leadership is still bringing up new and excellent innovations to see to the optimum performance of the industry, bringing down the cost of production, increasing revenue to government and the population. Our service instruments of licenses, permits and approvals enable business and create opportunities for investors in the Nigerian oil and gas industry. Yes, DPR is here for you. For more information on DPR, please visit our website www.dpr.gov.ng, Twitter at DPR Hotline and Instagram at DPR Hotline. Telephones plus 234-1279-0000 and 1903-7150.
Downstream Remote Monitoring System, DRMS, also known as eStation, is an inventory and regulatory tool that tracks product levels across retail outlets and depots. For more details, let's go to our special report.
The National Bureau of Statistics has it that the number of vehicles in the country has constantly been on the increase. As at the third quarter of 2017, it was put at about 11,547,236 vehicles on Nigerian roads, about 4,656,725 of these vehicles are privately owned, while 6,749,461 were registered as commercial vehicles. Another 135,216 were registered as government-owned vehicles, with another 5,834 registered as diplomats' vehicles. However, these numbers exclude construction and industrial machineries. As the numbers of these vehicles and machines increased, so also was the consumption of petroleum products in the country. In December 2018, petroleum consumption for Nigeria was put at 540,000 barrels per day. Statistics released by the Nigeria Bureau of Statistics showed that about 4.79 billion liters of premium motor spirit (PMS), popularly referred to as petrol, was consumed in the second quarter of 2018. The report also showed that 1.11 billion liters of automotive gas oil, that is diesel, while 43.79 million liters of household kerosene and 200.39 million liters of aviation turbine kerosene, respectively, within the same time were consumed. On the average, by the second quarter of 2020, Nigeria's consumption of petrol had increased to 52.67 million liters daily, while 12.15 million liters of automotive gas oil, AGO or diesel, was consumed within the same period. Also, the daily average consumption of household kerosene, HHK, and aviation turbine kerosene, ATK, was 481,000 and 2.2 million liters, respectively. The petroleum products consumption statistics for the third quarter of 2019 reflected that 5.09 billion liters of premium motor spirit (PMS), 1.18 billion liters of automotive gas oil (AGO), 12.83 million liters of household kerosene, HHK, 315.95 million liters of aviation turbine kerosene, ATK, 93 million liters of base oil, 38.57 million liters of bitumen, and 84,723 liters of liquefied petroleum gas LPG were imported into the country in the third quarter of 2019. Given the large volume of import and consumption of petroleum products, the launch of the Downstream Remote Monitoring System, DRMS, by the Department of Petroleum Resources, DPR, was a step in the right direction. The system, also known as the E-Station, is an inventory and regulatory tool that tracks product levels across retail outlets and depots. The system also tracks the movement of products from depots to retail outlets across the country. This means that at any given moment, the Department of Petroleum Resources should be able to know the products at any outlet and depot. It should be able to also track the movement of product leading trucks anywhere in the country. For a marketer to transmit data, that marketer will have to use the short code *7117# or DPR web portal https://estation.dpr.gov.ng. How can product depots and outlets be profiled? Marketers in Nigeria can profile their depot and outlet facilities on the Downstream Remote Monitoring System portal with ease using the following steps. Step 1. Visit https://estation.dpr.gov.ng or DPR website. Step 2. Click Register and create your company account on ELPS or use existing ELPS account if already registered. Step 3. Click the Proceed button. You will be redirected to log in via ELPS platform. Once you are successfully logged in, you will be redirected to the eStation page. Step 4. Enter a secure alphanumeric password and click Register. Step 5. Select if you want to register as an outlet or a depot. Step 6. Complete the setup by entering the required information, adding tanks and pumps where appropriate. Other steps include how to use USSD. Step 1. Dial *7117# on your mobile phone. Step 2. Follow the prompt on the screen. Does a depot or outlet owner need to register on eStation? The answer is yes, if you do not have an account on ELPS. No, if you already have an account on ELPS, in which case the system requires a new password. During the launch of the project, some petroleum products depot and outlet owners were grateful to the department, as this will help in no small measure in checking not only the excesses of depots and outlet attendants, but also the drivers and smugglers for outlets close to the international borders. The Director and Chief Executive Officer, DPR, Engineer Sarki Awalu, in reassuring depot and outlet owners, says DPR is here to assist them in their business.
This is a special announcement from the Department of Petroleum Resources. Gas is safe. Gas cylinders are to be kept outside. If you're buying LPG cylinder, look for NIS number on the cylinder. Exchange of gas cylinders with retailers during purchase is best practice instead of refilling from another cylinder. Buy gas from certified LPG plant. Repairing faulty gas cylinders is unsafe. For more information, visit the nearest DPR office or our website www.dpr.gov.ng.
Well, welcome back. And I hand you over to Femi Fabiebi for the question and answer segment of the program. Now, this is for more explanation on what Downstream Remote Monitoring System, DRMS, is all about. It's all yours, Femi.
Okay, thank you, Suleiman, and it's my pleasure to have you, dear viewer, on this interview segment of the program. My guest is no less a person than Malam Bashir. Sir, it's a pleasure to have you on the program, sir.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Now, my first question to you, sir, is what exactly is downstream remote monitoring as we hear it?
Yeah, the downstream remote monitoring system is a system that we developed in Department of Petroleum Resources, which is IT-based, to enable us monitor retail outlets, depots, and have a 360-degree view of the petroleum product distribution chain in the country.
Okay, sir, we understand that DRMS is a regulatory tool, you know, for tracking of products and outlets. Why adopting such a tool at this time?
Okay, you see, DRMS is part of our digitization program in the department, which started with the migration of oil and gas industry service permit to online processes. And we were able to now have our other licenses, like the license for retail outlets, depots, and so on and so forth. So it is the next thing that we need to do is to bring our regulatory monitoring into a digital platform so that we can have some efficiency and we can migrate that online as well.
Okay. Let me go, you know, a bit off from the line on which I was before to ask, what are the major benefits of DRMS to depot and filling station owners?
Yeah, there are a multitude of benefits to operators when this platform is eventually deployed. For instance, there is a reporting burden on marketers, our licensees. When we issue a license, you have a reporting burden. In the past, you have to do the report, do the stock, and bring it to us. Now you can do it online in the comfort of your home or your offices. And not only that, the DRMS system, we have made it in such a way that even if you do not have internet connection, you can use a USSD code to send this report to us. So in essence, you can fulfill the regulatory requirement of reporting without coming to DPR. And secondly, if you have multiple outlets or depots, you can use the tools to monitor your stock yourself. You know, you can know which filling station is selling more than the other. You can know which depot is loading more than the other. You can know, you know, the activities in the depots as they go on or at the filling station as they happen.
Still talking about benefits, sir, in what ways would DRMS benefit the DPR as the operator and the government itself?
Yes, for us as a department, it is going to encourage transparency. I will give you an instance. When we send out people for an inspection, it is what our people report to us that get to us. But if you have DRMS, this is a self-reporting tool with ability for us to verify. So you have a tendency of people reporting what actually is happening at the station. And this thing is being done on a daily basis. We do not have enough people to go around the whole filling stations and depots on a daily basis, on a continuous basis. With this tool, we are going to get all the information we need from the operators real time. Secondly, that is for transparency part. Secondly, for planning purposes, one of our major roles that the public may not be aware is the fact that we advise government on policies relating to petroleum industry. Once the best way to make policy is to make very good plan, and the data we expect to generate from DRMS will help us in planning energy security for the country.
Thank you, Malam Sadiq. And finally, on the issue of benefits, I know that the public, you know, should also be benefiting in one way or the other, whether now or in future, remotely or directly. What are the benefits?
Yeah, you know, eventually when DRMS takes hold very soon, you know, if you have a regulator that is efficiently doing its work and you have investors, that is station owners, that knows what profit they are making, eventually the public, the people will reap a lot of benefits. For instance, what we are looking at in the future, not very far from now, is the ability for us to put up a dashboard, a kind of a map of Nigeria with all the retail outlets and the status, and their status with regard to product availability. So if you are leaving your home, if you maybe it's either through app, we can even partner with readily available global service providers like Google and so on, so that if you go to your map, it will tell you which station is closest to you, what is the price they are selling, and what product they have. If you are buying diesel, that yes, station A is 2 kilometers from you and it has this product in this quantity, so that you can just, it saves you time and effort in searching and buying decision process.
Then I think I'll just have to ask straight away if this kind of move can checkmate smuggling and hoarding of petroleum products.
Yes, it will absolutely give us the ability to track product end to end. And if we are able to do that, it will definitely reduce smuggling because we'll be able to hold people accountable.
So, sir, now I'd like us to go into the nitty-gritty of the operations of DRMS. And I will ask this point, how will the marketers transmit data to the system?
Any marketer that we license, if you have a license from us, you are automatically profiled on DRMS. All you need to do is to key in by registering at e-stations, estation.gov.dpr.gov. So the information about your station or your depot will automatically be linked to DRMS. So that is one. If you go that route, that is, if you have internet service where you operate, you can go into e-stations, you register your facility, and then you are good to go. Every other process is intuitive. Initially, I mentioned something about USSD code. USSD code are for stations in rural areas, or if the internet fails you. If you do not have a very good internet connection, you can use the USSD. And what you do is you dial *7117# on any network in the country, and it will take you to the DRMS portal where you can impute the data, like the pump number, the sales you have done for the day, the product quantity you have. It is also just like what the banks are using, or if you are buying credit for your phone. When you dial that USSD code, it tells you that for one, pump number, two, your stock, three, so on and so forth. So it's intuitive and it's very easy to use, you know. So that is some of the things that we have put in place for operators to be able to make this report as easily as possible.
Now, is it a must, therefore, for them to register on eStation?
Yeah, it is a must. And why it is a must is, going forward, we are going to link renewal of licenses to people fulfilling the reporting burden or the reporting requirement of the DRMS. So what it does is basically what we do when we are renewing licenses is we go and check your operations for the last year. You know, if it is okay and your facility is in good shape, we renew your license.
Looking at the issue of the use of password in these processes, What of a situation where an operator forgets his or her password?
We have put in place some process for password recovery, just like you have with your email and other. There is a system in place to for whoever forget his password to recover. It's very easy.
Is it a must for a dealer to log in his or opening and closing stock every day?
Yes, that is the requirement of the system.
Finally, can you put a time, because the other time you said it's going to be soon, that it's going to be coming on stream. Can you put a time frame?
It is operational as we speak.
Thank you very much. Well, viewer, I've been having a time out with Malam Bashir Sadiq, and I'm sure you must have picked up very valuable information from this interview segment. It's my pleasure to be here, and I hope to see you sometime very soon. Let me hand you over to Suleiman.
It's here I draw the curtain on today's program. But first, many thanks to the Department of Petroleum Resources for their constant innovation to monitor and check the excesses of some persons who are out to wreak havoc in the industry. Yes, if you see any, do inform DPR. Many thanks for watching. Goodbye.